Oh, Daddy, what's a crane? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a crane? When I was just a boy, a-living by the track, us kids together up to coal in a big old gunny sack. We heard the warning sound as the train pulled into view. The engineer would smile and wave as she went rolling through. She blew so loud and clear, we had to cover up our ears. We counted cars just as high as we could go. I can almost hear the steam and the big old driver scream with a sound my little boy will never know. Oh, Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train? I guess the times have changed. Kids are different now. But some don't even seem to know that milk comes from a cow. My little boy can tell the names of all the baseball stars. I remember how we memorized the names on railroad cars. The Wabash and the TP, Lackawanna and the IC, yeah, the nickel plate, the good old Santa Fe. Just names out of the past, I guess they're fading fast. Every time I hear my little boy say, Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train? We climbed into the car and rolled down into town, right up to the depot house, but no one was around. We searched the yard together for something I could show. I knew there hadn't been a train for a dozen years or so. All the things I did when I was just a kid, how far away those old memories appear. And I guess it's plain to see they still mean a lot to me, because my ambition was to be an engineer. Oh, Daddy, what's a train? Is it something I can ride? Does it carry lots of grown-up folks and little kids inside? Is it bigger than our house? Well, how can I explain when my little boy asked me, Daddy, what's a train?
Cause it's never been beat, and we never missed it with the girls we meet. Well, now the guys go steady, cause it wouldn't be right to have the best girl.
Get around. do stand, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me. As you stand, stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me.
I love the colorful clothes she wears, and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle moon on the wind that blows so perfume through the air.
I'm picking up her vibrations, she's giving me the excitations.
Softly smile, I know she must be fine. In her eyes, she goes with me to a blossom moon.
She's my excitation, my good vibration.
There's a woman, old and gray, sits down by the loading section every day, waiting for the Portsmouth train to bring her boy from war. But for 14 years, the Portsmouth train don't stop here anymore. And I guess her ghost will haunt her post when she is gone. And my arms get heavy, my back gets sore as the afternoon wears on. And the work ain't always easy, but it's seldom far from hard. Such is the life of a section hand in the New York Central Yard. Dutch McGann, I knew him well. Switch engine gave a jerk, old Dutchie slipped and fell. And all he'd left to show for a life that's worked away was a sickly wife, four hungry kids, and a mortgage they can't pay. They gave us 3 hours of free time and a box of pine. So we dug his grave, laid him in down by the outbound line. And oftentimes I've sat and I've tipped my hat to my one-time good old pard. Such is the life of the section hand in the New York Central. Gonna move out west, state my claim. Dig myself a homestead and forget my name. And steal me an engine just to see how fast she'll go. Watch them drivers tear up track and hear that whistle blow. But the first red streaks were in the east when I punched in. And the moon will be above the maple tree before I get home again. And the roof needs fixing, the kids need shoes, Molly needs a bucket of lard. Such is the life of a section hand in the New York Central Yard.